Voilà. Tonight I'm gonna tell you how a book, a pissing helicopter pilot, a monkey, a black prostitute, and a commando sports car made me become an entrepreneur. During my entire student life, I had a picture on my desk. And every time I wanted to give up on studying, this guy stared at me and made me realize I did it all for him. That guy is me. Because I have been very happy since, I decided to share with you some experiences which helped me go on in my life. This is my father. He told me to become a pilot or accountant because these are the best paid jobs in Holland and I needed to get rich, he said. Since I didn't think the same about that and I didn't think money was the meaning of life, I didn't know what I had to do when I finished high school. Kids who finish high school in Holland normally take a world trip to find themselves before choosing what to study. The only thing I knew was that I didn't want to become a pilot or an accountant. So when all my friends took an airplane to fly across the world finding themselves, I took my bike and went to the library, typed in the database Money and the Meaning of Life, and I found this book called Money and the Meaning of Life. This was my first lesson, that money is not important, but you should not, it's important, but you should not let it dominate your life. And because all my friends were abroad and I was still searching for the meaning of life, I decided to start working in an office building where people in suits live. Because I want to prove myself that the most horrible thing in life is to wear a suit. One day in the office I was standing in the toilet next to my manager, who told me he used to be a helicopter pilot for the army. But he also told me that being a manager is 10 times much more exciting to him. So that was my second lesson, that people in suits can be cool. Knowing that money isn't everything, I choose to study sociology. Not afraid of guys in suits anymore, I also started to work at an insurance company. Once I saw an insurance for a company that tested monkeys, and I told my colleague, should we insure this company or not? And my colleague said, no, we're going to stop this insurance directly because ethics is more important than money. And that was the first day I went home from work smiling and whistling, and I was totally happy, and I decided I don't going to work for money anymore, I'm going to work to be happy and do good things. As a kid, I grew up in the Cold War, and I learned that behind the big wall in Europe, there were scary people who all dressed the same, drove the same cars, and they were called communists, and they were really scary. And I didn't believe it, but I was fascinated, and I went to Eastern Europe to find out myself, and it was absolutely not true. So I fell in love in Eastern Europe and started working there for an NGO. One day, an older Macedonian colleague told me, when we were in Amsterdam, that you always have to do everything you want to do in your life before you die, and don't regret it. Directly, 1 hour later, we were in Amsterdam, he went to the red light district and did something he always wanted to do, to sleep with a black woman. And I learned to do everything you want to do before life is over. A few years later, I was walking through North Mitrovica and saw a Skoda 110. I fell in love, found one for sale in Czech Republic, bought a Mercedes in Holland to drive there, gave the owner 2,500 euros and my Mercedes, and on the way back home in Germany, I blew the engine of my new car. 4 months and 6,000 euros later, the car was finally in Holland where I never drove it. I sold it for 500 euros. Although I didn't regret following my heart, I learned that I also should use my mind. This last experience was of essential importance to where I am now. 8 months ago, I decided to follow my heart. I stopped a great, well-paid job in Holland, packed one suitcase and moved here. I started a social company, taking people on a bike tour through Belgrade. 7 months ago, I had nothing left. And now I have 9 employees, 2 companies, and a lot of fun every day. Thanks to a book, a pissing helicopter pilot, a monkey, a black prostitute, and a vintage communist sports car. And the lessons I learned from them. You might think this story is a bit crazy or makes no sense, but I believe that all the moments that I just shared with you are important to me. I was in doubt if I should give this presentation or if I should tell you about the way I started my companies. But last night I was reading The Economist and I read a review of the new book of Richard Branson, one of the greatest entrepreneurs in the world. His book is called Screw Business as Usual. Branson always used to say, have fun and the money will come. But later in his new book, he changed it into do good, have fun, and the money will come. And that's exactly what I wanted to share with you tonight, and exactly what I believe as well. And I want to give you one advice. If you need to get inspired, and there's nobody around you to inspire you, just to think about for who you're doing it. You're doing it for the future of yourself when you are little. Thank you very much.